The U.S. Geological Survey has done a study into fecal matter, human fecal matter, raw sewage, and whether or not that raw sewage can become profitable. Now, it's profitable in a very unexpected way. Apparently, there are precious metals in our poo, and the researchers want to extract those precious metals and possibly use them as profit. So let me give you an example of this. It's absolutely insane. According to an 8-year study by the U.S. Geological Survey, they found that levels of precious metals in feces was comparable with those found in some commercial mines. What?
Holy crap.
Okay. You're the worst. All right. Trace amounts of metals are found in cosmetics, shampoos, and even clothes. Some food and drinks also now contain flakes of gold and silver. So you consume these precious metals, oftentimes unwittingly. They are, taken out of your body by the natural process.
That's true, then they end up
in the sewage systems. And also, a lot of people lose jewelry when they accidentally throw it down the drain. Mm-hmm. Okay, and so they're thinking, the researchers in this case are thinking, why are we just going to leave these precious metals behind? Why don't we find a way to extract them? Previous research estimated the waste from 1 million Americans could contain as much as 8.7 million pounds worth of metals.
You know, sometimes they say, oh, what, your shit don't stink? Like, no, you don't understand. My shit not only doesn't stink, it's full of gold.
It's full of gold.
I've got golden poo. This is amazing, man. You know, you always hear the stories about the dollar bills, like 98% of them have cocaine on them. Mm-hmm. You're like, how the hell did that happen? Because they just keep getting recirculated, etc. But I didn't know we were eating. And so this is amazing because, you know, there's the oldest science was alchemy, where they try to turn non-precious metals into precious metals. Take a metal that isn't worth that much and turn it into gold. Mm-hmm. Little did they know, they actually could turn shit into gold.
Yep.
We have mastered the greatest form of alchemy.
So here's the question. Is there a good way, an efficient way, to extract the precious metals from the human waste? And also, aside from the precious metals that you'll obtain through doing this, there's another great upside to it. You will be able to use the human waste as fertilizer, and it won't be harmful to the environment.
Because the metals then sometimes hurt whatever you've put the fertilizer in.
Yeah.
So it's a win-win for everybody. The question is, can you do it efficiently enough? Obviously, you've got to do it on a mass scale, so don't dig in tonight and be like, wait, there's gold in these hills. Don't do that. Okay. So, but maybe scientists can figure out a way to actually just make things a little bit more efficient, find a filtering process
Yes.
where we get the gold and the better fertilizer.
Right, and it's not just gold, it's platinum, silver, other precious metals, so that's good news. Oftentimes when we talk about scientists, I get a little jealous because they're so incredibly intelligent and a lot of them are innovative and they do so many great things for society. But these are researchers that I'm not jealous of. I have no interest in that. I have no interest in looking for gold and poop.
You're right, because all day long they gotta be dealing with poop, right? They gotta be like, all right, hey Bob, what'd you find?
Hey. No interest.
Oh, you want to check this out? Look, but you know what? They go into work and they think, that's all right. Shit happens.
Shit happens. I feel like you already did that joke. No?
No, I didn't. Okay. I know. I had it in my back pocket.
All right. Well, you nailed it, Cenk.